This is a journey UT Knoxville's Gary McCracken has been on countless times, deep into the forests of Tennessee. It's a journey to save bats in North America.
It started in the winter of 2006, and no one really knew what was happening. When they first started seeing large numbers of bats dying, and then it took about a year until it was associated with a fungus that was growing on the bats as they were hibernating.
The fungus, Geomyces destructens, causes a disease called white nose syndrome, aptly named for the white smudges it leaves on bats' noses. The disease is spreading at an alarming rate, killing more than 1 million bats in the first 3 years and pushing some species near extinction.
Since 2006, this fungus has moved very rapidly across much of the United States. So it's spread both north and south from New York State. So it's up in Maine, and it's into Canada and Ontario and Quebec, all down through Massachusetts and Pennsylvania and Virginia and West Virginia. And last year, in late winter, early spring, we first saw it in Tennessee. But one of the first colonies, or the first areas to find the fungus, was right here at White Oak Sink, a White Oak Sink blowhole, which is a the largest known hibernacula for Indiana bats, federally listed endangered species.
Caves like White Oak have been closed to people across the country to help stop the spread of white nose. It's believed the fungus, which doesn't harm humans, is being transported on people's clothing, further spreading the disease. McCracken is tracking the spread of white nose by slithering into the dark, cool mouths of caves and installing bat detectors.
This is a bat detector. It's a type of bat detector that's called an anabat. It records the echolocation calls, the ultrasonic calls that bats make when they're flying.
White nose strikes in the wintertime, a time when bats store up energy, but also a time when their immune systems run low. Scientists know if a bat has likely contracted white nose if its hibernation is disrupted. A telltale sign is unusual flight activity, such as flying in the middle of the day and flying often.
Normally, during hibernation, bats will spontaneously arouse every 2 to 3 weeks or so. Every time they arouse, they utilize fat that they would need to survive the winter.
McCracken's detectors measure bat calls every time the bats enter and exit the mouth of the cave. The data showed positive news.
So I have no evidence of daytime flights, no, which is great. And I do have evidence of nighttime flights, which is also great, because I think it really would be to their advantage if the animals were able to get out at night in the winter and get some food.
But McCracken warns not to rush to judgment. White nose has proven to be a formidable opponent, and only time will tell if it will stop before it's too late.
Whether this is going to be good in the long run, or whether it's only going to take one more year or two more years for the populations to be decimated, at this stage, we don't know.